Hello everyone. So you're looking at my analysis of voltage and amperage in the electron. And I'm going to attempt to go at it here because I think I've got it figured out. And so let's do it. It's all about spin. There's two directions of spin and there's two paths of direction. So we'll start with voltage here and amperage. And we know that we have a magnetic component and we have an electric component. We have a left and a right, a positive potential, I call this phase, and a negative potential. So it's in phase and it's out of phase, okay, on the electric side. And it's in phase and out of phase on the magnetic side, means there's magnetic component here and no magnetic component here. And it means there is electric component here and no electric component here. So they're doing, as Don says, partially, I don't agree with what he says. I do in some aspects, but there's more to it. And that's what I'm going to go at right here. So in the voltage electron, it's doing, as Don would say, the infinitive loop. It flips and it flips and it flips and it flips. Okay, that's not entirely correct. It's more advanced than that, but yes, the electron itself flips. I believe there to be a single electron, one electron, and it spins in there's two electrons. There's one electron, but it's spinning in two different directions in two different paths. But again, the electron is the electron. So one electron becomes paired with another electron spinning in the opposite direction. One is volts and one is amps. They spin together, they flip, and then they go about their separate paths. I'm going to explain that to you. So we understand the magnetic component, plus and minus. I just went through that. And the electric component, and they're going like this. And as they're going like this, the other half of it is going in the opposite by 90 degrees. And we're going to get to that. So that's the voltage. So now the amperage is doing the same thing. I didn't draw it in. You know, you've got your electron. But the figure 8, or the infinity sign, is actually up here. And this is a complete understanding of volts and amps. And it looks like this. And one is running clockwise, and the other is running counterclockwise. One is running at A440 and the other is running at A432. Okay, so volts and amps. Now, in the complete illustration of the flow path of the volts and amps, I've labeled phase here so you can see that we've got a left and a right, a negative and a negative because we're in the lower plane, and a positive because we're above the ambient plane of zero unity. And so let's trace a voltage electron that starts right here. Okay, one electron. This electron is going in this direction. It's traveling all the way around. And here at this point in time, we have an electric component in a positive phase. Now we have an electric component in a magnetic or in a negative phase. And then it comes back, it goes through this loop, and we have a magnetic component in a positive polarity or phase, and it flows around the rest of the loop, and we have a magnetic component in negative phase or out of phase. Then this same electron comes up here and produces a amps component in the positive phase. So this would be forward-leading amperage. It comes up here, it goes out of phase, becomes lagging amperage, comes back down here, and it becomes the magnetic component or scalar component of amperage. That comes down here, and it's in the negative in phase, and like leading. And here it's lagging in phase, and it comes back up, and it starts the whole process over again. So an electron actually goes like this, And this is one cycle of an electron where the electron, in this instance, is a volts, a voltage. So it's actually, when it flips, it's flipping between A440 and A432, which one is one and one is one. So if this is the voltage, and this is A440, and it's running with time, and the amperage is A432, and it's running below time, like in space, or scalar amperage, and okay, so we got a handle on that. That's one part of it. Now, these electrons are paired because we de-spin them and re-spin them, and recombine the pairs and so forth. And so the one is going in one direction, and one is going in the other direction, and they meet right here where they become paired. After they become out of phase, or from one component's phase, say the magnetic component and the electric component, when those phases shift, they start to pair again. They break the pair here, and they start to repair here until they're at unity here, joined at their highest vibratory state. And then again, they go through their separate paths, and they break their pair, and so forth. This cycle carries on. Now, whether they're exactly paired like this, or if one is pushing the other, I think is more the situation, because they're in perpetual exchange between the two okay, so this gets really detailed, but they're in perpetual exchange with a variance of 8 hertz minus the speed of sound from the source. So if the source is the sun and the moon that are binding the electrons, then the distance of, or the length of time it takes for an emission from the sun and an emission from the moon to exchange with the surface of the earth, unity, is the 8 hertz that we experience, or 7.8 hertz magnetic field of time. So in Earth, our frequency is 7.8 hertz, or in that range, say 8 hertz, minus the speed of sound. And that's what's binding all this together. So anyways, we won't go too crazy into that yet, but this is how I believe an electron flows in two paths. And then we can see here that one electron, the electron is all the same. It doesn't matter if it's a volts, or if it's an amps component, if it's spinning in one clockwise direction or counterclockwise direction, it is the same damn thing. And those become polarized the further they get away when they're breaking away. And like I say, this could be a whole chain of them, and the faster one's pushing the slower one, and they just keep going around and around and repelling each other like this in this infinite loop. So there's a 90-degree coupling here. If we look at what we understand currently, there's actually 4 waves here because we have the phase component. So if we've got amps going out in the upward direction here, vertical, if this is going out at 90 degrees here, the voltage is going down. So this is a negative voltage potential. That's why there's a voltage here. This should be negative beside it. And there's a negative amperage potential when it's going that way. So if you know what I mean. So now this amperage here would also be over here, which is what's shown here. But it would be 180 degrees. It would be on a flat a horizontal plane to the vertical plane voltage. So when this is on the other phase, it's over here, and then it's back to this phase. So call this phase one, this phase two on the amps, and the volts is the same, high volts, no volts, right? So electric, magnetic, and the same here, magnetic, electric, and they're doing this, and there's, like I said, a mirror of this, so there's actually 4. It would just look like this. There's 4 components. So you got voltage, amperage, amperage. Okay, so you have a phase like this, and then the voltage, you have a phase like this, something like that. It's hard for me to visualize, like to draw. It's not hard for me to visualize it, but I'm not really an artist. But you get that there's four different parts to this, and that's exactly what's going on here. And that's exactly how an electron flows. And it transmutes and becomes an amperage electron. And then it repeats the cycle after it travels. One electron travels all four of these loops. And it flips four times. And as it flips, it's spinning and despinning from the paired electron that it's meeting, that is in the same reinforcing spin. When they come together, they're both spinning the same direction, reinforcing one another, racing around. And then they flip and they come despun, one spinning one way and one spinning the other way. They're attracting here and they're repelling here, if you get what I mean. They're attracting here and they're repelling here. And these things just carry on. So that's my analysis. One electron, two directions. Two directions, two paths. Ciao.